Thanks, Tim. It's great to be out here. As Tim said, this equipment that we're going to show you in a second was in our Allen Park facility for a number of years. And when Harold Nash, our new strength and conditioning coach, arrived, and I'll introduce Harold to you in a second, Harold came in and wanted to redo the fitness room and the weight room, and we talked about how we would go about that and what we might do with the equipment that we had in place. And to me, there was only one place I thought of that would be the perfect place to donate our former equipment to, and as Tim said, he and I met, we talked about the donation, we talked to his team, and our two teams coordinated taking down all this equipment that you're going to see in a second and reassembling it behind us. As Tim mentioned, the Lions and Pal have a long history going all the way back to our great player, Night Train Lane, being on their board, all the way through the donations that he mentioned, up to, including today, the Quick Lane Bowl that is at Ford Field. One of the beneficiaries of the bowl is still Pal today. So we're very, very excited about continuing this relationship, expanding it, and continuing all the great work that Pal does with the youth in Detroit.
Well, first of all, I want to thank you all. It is my pleasure to come out and be a part of this great, great historic event. Obviously, we want to thank the Ford family for everything they've done in this community. This is just an A1 organization. So I want to thank them first. Also want to thank Rod Wood. He's done a phenomenal job. The vision that he has for the team and the organization, we're just going to follow his lead. Bob Quinn, general manager, as well as Coach Caldwell. They've all, you know, kind of put our minds together and said, you know, all of our hearts are with this community of Detroit. Myself, I had the privilege to come here a couple times before this and actually deposit some of the equipment myself and my assistant Josh Shuler. And when we got here, we said, you just see the vision. And we had the privilege to really see some men who really have a heart, a genuine heart for this community and these kids. I too come from the same type of arena. I'm from the inner city of New Orleans. So I totally understand the challenges that we're faced. But sometimes you just have to give a kid a chance. You gotta give him an opportunity. And I think that's what these men and women do in Detroit. So there's something special here. Sometimes it's not as visual as you may think it is, but it's there. Somebody has a heart and they really genuinely want to improve the community. All you need is a willing subject. So, you know, as the scripture says, you know, the laborers, you know, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. And I think that's the scenario. But we had the privilege when I came in and I saw the equipment and I said, maybe we need to change some things around. But this is some great equipment. So sometimes you sit there and say, man, this is some great equipment. It needs to go to good use. And the only option we thought of was Pal. So when they told me, I said, that's a great organization. Let's do it. And we had the opportunity to kind of put it in. And I think some of the, not just the kids, but I think some of the hierarchy used it too. They're here every morning working out. And so it's some awesome equipment. It's not like a hand-me-down type thing. I think it's solid. It's going to really improve and help guys come along. So I also look forward to coming here from time to time, bringing my son. He's a teenager, and we all just sort of involved in that. So it is my privilege actually to be here and be able to do this. But again, it's not me. It's definitely not me. I'm just a person that they use.